Hi, ladies and gentlemen. I hope everyone is doing well today. Today we're taking a look at pH and pOH. To calculate pH and pOH, we do have to use some logs and negative logs. So questions, the introduction questions are just reminding us about logs, how to type in our calculator, how to get answers. So questions 1A and B, just type in what it says. Question 2. So question 2 is a verify question, so we need to type this into our calculators. I'm sorry, I forgot a calculator at school, all of them at school, but I can show you on my phone how to do it, what it would look like. That's kind of cool. I wonder why that happens. But actually, now on to the question. So if we look at question 2, we're taking the negative log. So we start by hitting the negative sign. My phone calculator automatically puts a parentheses there. If you're using a calculator, you do not have to do that. Then we would type log. Then we would type in 0.39, oops, 390. Really important, make sure we close the parentheses correctly. So I close the first parentheses there. I close the second parentheses in front. And I hit enter. I get 0.409. So just like I typed in question 2, you can type the 3A, B, and C into your calculator to get answers. So now we have some information on calculating pH. So from the pH activity lab, hopefully you remember that the pH is a measure of the concentration of the hydronium ions in the solution. You should also remember that the pH ranges from 0 to 14. And then you should also remember that below 7 is acidic, above 7 is basic. When the pH is 7, it's neither neutral, sorry, it's neutral, it's neither acidic or basic. A couple of other things that are new. So this first sentence is new. Whenever you have square back brackets around the hydrogen ion, H plus, that means concentration, so it means molarity. So up here we have our pH formula. pH equals the negative log of your hydrogen ion, hydronium ion, in brackets. So pH is equal to the negative log of your concentration of hydrogen, hydronium ion. So question 4, we are going to calculate the pH of this solution. So that doesn't tell you what the solution is, but it tells us the concentration of hydronium ions. So we know that the concentration of hydrogen is 2.5 times 10 to the negative 3. So then we write that. Remember, brackets tell us concentration. We can then use our pH formula, which is pH equals the negative log of our hydronium ion concentration, of our hydrogen ion concentration. Remember, I just got that from up there. Then we can plug in our hydrogen concentration. So we know that the pH is equal to the negative log of H plus. So we would type in 2.5 times 10 to the negative 3. So again, I guess I'll show you this one on my phone calculator too. I just gotta get it to turn. Ah, there we go. So I'll slide it up. That's really cool. It changes the color. So you can start by typing in the negative. Remember, my calculator puts a parenthesis in front. If you're doing it on a real calculator, I don't think you need that. So we would type in the log 2.5 times 10. So remember, it depends on your calculator. You may have the caret, you may have this x with a y where the exponent goes. I have the x with a y, so then I type that in and it puts a caret in there for me. And then again, negative 3. So as you can see here, I added a bunch of parentheses, so we just have to make sure to close them all. So we have to close the first one that the negative 3 is in. We have to close the next one that comes after the caret. We have to close the one that's between the g and the 2. And then we need to close the one in front. So then we hit enter, and we get 2. pH equals 2.60. So for all, you guys can round to two decimal places on this ChemQuest. That's probably a good place. So pH 2.60. So next, question 5. Question 5, we need to calculate the concentration of HNO3. This is nitric acid. So I mean, I know what it's called, but the telltale sign that this is an acid is you have a hydrogen in front. Whenever you have a hydrogen in front, usually that's an acid. That's the telltale sign that gives it away. Remember from the previous ChemQuest, remember that acids donate hydrogens. So we can write out the dissociation, and then we can use the coefficients to calculate the concentration of our hydronium ion. So I'll do that with you right now. So then remember, we know that this acid is going to donate a hydrogen. So this is going to break up into H plus and NO3 minus. So to get the charge of nitrate, you could do this two ways. You could look it up on our list, or you can know that hydrogens are positive, so if a hydrogen leaves, that must become negative since it was neutral before it broke up. Then we can use our coefficients to calculate the concentration of our hydronium ion, of our hydrogen. So it's a 1-to-1 ratio, so we know that the concentration will equal the concentration of nitric acid times 1. And it's the reason why is because you have the same amount of hydrogen ion as you do nitric acid. So then our concentration of hydrogen ion is 0.057. So in part B, it's asking us to calculate the pH. You can calculate the pH the same way as I did in 4, using the pH formula. pH equals the negative log of hydronium ion. Oh. I guess it's a little blurry. There we go. So you just use the pH formula in part B. So then next, up top, we have question 6. So question 6 is, what is the pH of a 0.0085 molar solution of hydrochloric acid? So when you do 6, you're going to set it up similarly how we did 5A and B. So you need to break the hydrochloric acid up. Remember, HCl is an acid. So remember the telltale sign is that hydrogen ion in the front. It tells us that it's an acid. So it will break up similarly how I broke up HNO3 in 5A. Whoops. It'll break up very similarly to how I did it here, except instead of having nitrate, you'll have chlorine. Next, then you're going to find the hydronium ion concentration by using the coefficients, and then you can find the pH using the pH formula. So then next we have some information on pOH. So it reminds us that when acid is placed in water, it donates hydrogen ions. Well, a base is the opposite. When a base is placed in water, a base produces hydroxide ions. I wrote hydronium in here. I meant to write hydroxide. Whoops. So pOH is the measure of hydroxide ions in the solution. And it is the exact opposite of pH. So your pH formula is pH equals the negative log of hydronium ions. Your pOH is the negative log of hydroxide ions. So then similarly, we move down to question 7. So question 7, it gives us the concentration of hydroxide ions, and it's asking us to calculate the pOH. So we know that the pOH equals the negative log of OH minus. So then we just need to plug in our 4.0 times 10 to the negative 12, where it's OH minus, because remember, brackets are concentration or molarity. So then we know that pOH equals the negative log 4.0 times 10 to the negative 12. When you solve that, your answer is 11. You should be able to get 11.397 as your answer. I wanted to show you how this rounds. Whoops, sorry, I got cut off. So remember, we're going to 2 decimal places. Remember, this is where rounding is tricky. The 7 rounds this up to a 10, so then the 1 gets added to the 3. So this becomes 11.40, and that is your pOH. In question 8, you need to find out which relationship is true. Whatever relationship you find is true for all solutions. Whatever answer you get, whichever one you find, you can use this relationship to calculate pH or pOH if you know one or the other. So when you're doing number 8, so we're using questions 4 and 7 because they go together. So remember, the pH you found was 2.6 in number 4. The pOH that you found in 7 was 11.40. So now you can plug in your relationships until you find, you can plug in your values for pH and pOH until you find the correct relationship. So number 9, it tells us a pH. So once you know your correct relationship from 8, you can plug in the pH where it says pH and then solve for the missing pOH. If you know either the pH or the pOH, you can always quickly solve for the other one by using the correct formula for number 8. Question 10. So question 10, we have the pH of a 0, pH is of a 0.025 molar solution of calcium hydroxide. And it's asking us to calculate the pH. So remember, this is a base. We know this is a base since it does not have hydrogen in the front, but it gives us a pH. So we need to calculate the pOH. So to do this, the first thing we're going to need is the concentration of OH minus hydroxide ion. So we know that the hydroxide ion is twice the concentration of this, and we know that because it's little 2 right there. So the first thing to do when we're is to calculate the hydroxide ion. So to calculate the hydroxide ion, we would do 0.025 times 2, which gives us 0.05 concentration of hydroxide ion. So then next, we need to calculate the pOH. So remember, pOH is equal to the negative log of OH minus, which we have right up here. That gives us the pOH. Then to calculate the pH, which we're eventually trying to find, is you can use your relationship from question 8. Question 8, you should have found that the pH plus the pOH equals 14. So you can plug your answer, whatever you get here, into the pOH. Then you can solve for the pH by subtracting on both sides. Question 11. So question 11, it's showing us how to work backwards. So when we work backwards, we know when we're trying to calculate the hydronium ion, we can use the pH. I type this in one step, but the point of A is to remind you that you do need to have the negative pH. So you have negative 2.45, because remember it's negative pH, not just pH, and it got blurry again. Cool. So then we know that H plus concentration will equal 10 to negative 2.45. When you type this into your calculator, remember to put your negative pH in parentheses. I'm not sure if you actually need it, but I always do it this way just to be safe. I would hate for a silly mistake like that, and parentheses never hurt. Question 12. So question 12, a certain solution has a pH of 5.2. What is the concentration of hydronium ions? So you're just basically solving what we just did in 11. We're using our formula for hydronium ions, H plus, equals the 10 to negative pH. Do not forget to take the negative number. I always put that in parentheses. 13a. So 13a, we're finding the pH, the pOH from question 12. So we use equation 8. So if you remember, the equation from question 8 is the pH plus the pOH equals 14. So you can plug in your pH. Whoops, my pencil. You can plug in your pH to where it says pH. And then you can solve for the pOH. Next, so 14b. 14b, now we're calculating the hydroxide ion, OH minus. So just like the calculating the pH, calculating the pOH are opposites of each other, calculating the concentration is also opposite of each other. So we know that the hydroxide ion concentration is 10 to negative pOH. So once you have your pOH from question 13, you can plug it into question 14 and then type in, sorry, 13A, you can plug it into 13B and then solve for the pOH. You should get an answer of 1.60 times 10 to the negative 9. Question 14 is another relationship question. Whichever answer you find here is always true. So we need to use our pHs from questions 12 and 13b. So I have it written down. Where did I write it down? Oh, so for question 12, hopefully you got that the concentration is 6.3 times 10 to the negative 6 for hydronium ion. For hydroxide ion, it's 1.60 times 10 to the negative 9th. So again, you can plug these values in to formulas A, B, and C, and you should find a relationship. Whatever relationship you find is always true. We're not going to use this relationship too much in this chem quest, but we will start exploring it in the next one. So then for the last couple questions, 15, 16, 17, and 18, you can look through the chem quest and you can see what formulas we use for which types of problems. Then you can solve. So a couple things that I wanted to remind you of to help you get started. So in question 15, NgOH2 is a base. Remember, we know this is a base because there's no hydrogen in front. That's usually a telltale sign of an acid. So then 16, over here we have an acid. We have a hydrogen ion in front, or hydrogen in front. Question 17, again, we have an acid because we have the hydrogen in front. Question 18, we're working with two bases. I guess it's the same base, calcium hydroxide. And remember, we know that this is a base because there's no hydrogen in front. So for all of these questions, we've solved similar examples throughout the Chem Quest already. Look up those questions, look at how I showed you how to solve them, look at how you solved the one that came after, and try to mimic your steps. Like always, if you have any questions, please make sure you circle them and bring them to class. I hope everyone has a good day.